Hello students, with only few months left for the final examinations, I will be revising with you organic chemistry. And in this matter, our revision lectures are going to be the things which are most important for the coming examinations. In this matter, first of all, I would like to discuss the important name reactions of the organic chemistry, which are very important and are usually asked in the CBSE, IIT and NEET and GE examinations. So today's talk is going to be on the Wurtz reaction. Wurtz reaction is a coupling reaction. As I have written, the alkyl halide is treated with sodium in the presence of dry ether and you are getting an alkane which contains double the number of carbon atoms which were present in this alkyl halide. So this involves the coupling of two R groups. Example, if I give you CH3CH2Br, if I react with sodium in the presence of dry ether, what will be the product of this? This is my dry ether. You can see that this is going to leave, this is sodium bromide, and this coupling is going to take place. The result is the formation of CH3CH2CH2 CH3 plus 2 NaBr. This is positive. This is. So what we find, the coupling has taken place, and you can see that from here what I am getting is an even number of carbons. If I have two carbons, I am getting four carbons. You are always going to get even number of carbons in the product. The important points in this reaction is that in this reaction, first, if I use symmetric type of alkyl halides, the yields are better and what we get is a double the number of carbons. Then I cannot use this method to prepare this. This cannot be prepared by this method because methane has only one carbon, whereas you find that when I will use CH3Br, if I use CH3Br with sodium in the presence of ether, the product will be CH3CH3. So we will get two carbons instead of one. Therefore, it is not possible to prepare methane by this reaction. The minimum possibility is ethane, which has two carbons. Further, you can see that the yields are not that good. About 60% yields are obtained for 1 degree alkyl halides. And if I use tertiary alkyl halides, it does not work, cannot be prepared by this method, because in tertiary alkyl halides elimination reactions takes place and therefore you will get alkenes. Moreover, as you can see, it is not possible to get the pure products. There will always be some byproducts because of the mechanism of the reaction, which we will discuss very soon. Now what you are finding, that in this case CH3CH2 is going to give you 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atoms, and we cannot prepare the tertiary alkyl halides. If I will use that, there will be elimination possibility and you will get alkenes. Let us see the mechanism of the reaction. This involves a radical mechanism. For example, if I take CH3CH2Br in step 1, what is going to happen when I react with sodium? What is there? Sodium has got one electron in the outermost shell, and in this case what will happen when sodium approaches this? This is example of homolytic fission. The result is that sodium will give its electron to this Br, and the result of this will be CH3CH2 plus, what you are getting? Na plus Br minus. So you have generated a radical. Now this radical is having only one electron, therefore is a very reactive species. It is in need of one electron, and what it will do, that it will snatch this electron. It will snatch this electron from the sodium which is present, because large number of atoms of sodium are present in the reaction mixture. So sodium will again give its electron to this, and this will result in the formation of what you are getting now, Na plus. This is now a carbon ion, a carbon carrying a negative charge. Carbon carrying a negative charge. This is also a reactive species, and this is now going to act as a nucleophile. Nucleophile. So what it will do? This is a nucleophile. This will attack the alkyl halide. As Br is negative, this carbon is positive. So this will likely to attack this carbon. The result of this is that this Br is also in need of electron. More electronegative, it will take these electrons and leave. And the result of this is CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3 plus Br minus. Sodium plus is already present, Br already present. This is my product which I am getting. So I am writing that there are three steps. This reaction involves, the mechanism of the reaction involves three steps. As you can see, radical and then nucleophile attack on the carbon. Therefore, this is my product. It is a coupling reaction. There, the three steps are important, and that is why, because there are radicals, there will be some more products. And in the case of tertiary, you will see that elimination possibilities are there. Therefore, tertiary alkyl halides are not used in this type of reaction. The question is that why you are using dry ether? Because if I use water, the water will react with sodium. It is a very explosive reaction, you already know that. Therefore, the water presence is not required. It should be dry ether. It should be dry ether. Such a question has already been asked in the examination. Now let me solve one or two questions on this. Question number one. CH3, CH2, CH, Cl plus CH3. Reacts with sodium in the presence of dry ether. What is the product? This is nothing but example of the Wurtz reaction. The best way to do for these students is that you will put this compound in this form. I am writing it like this. Now I am putting sodium. Then I am writing another this compound, CH, Cl, CH2, CH3. Now the product is clear. This is my ether. So what will happen? This will leave, and coupling will take place at this carbon and this carbon. The result is CH3, CH2, CH, CH3. What you are getting? CH. This is CH3. This is CH3. What you are getting? CH3, CH2, CH3. So this is my product, and NaCl is there. So what is the name of this compound? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is my 3, 4 dimethyl hexane. 3, 4 dimethyl hexane. Another reaction example I am giving. Question 2. CH, CH3, CH2Br reacts with sodium in the presence of dry ether. Write the product. Now again, in this case, you already know that this is the Br and Na which will leave, and coupling reaction will take place. On the same basis, I can write the product of this CH3, CH, CH3, CH2. So CH2, CH, CH3. Further CH3, and what is leaving? 2NaBr. So what is the name of this compound? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is my 2,5 dimethyl hexane. So this is the first reaction which I have discussed. In my next video, I will discuss the other similar type of reactions, Wurtz-Fittig reaction and Fittig reaction, which are important for your exams.